You're watching UNICEF television. In 2005, UNICEF launched a campaign to put children at the centre of the international effort to stop the spread of AIDS. Each year it issues a stocktaking report that charts the campaign's progress. This year's success story is the drop in the number of mothers who are passing the disease along to their children.
There's been remarkable scale up, and that the majority of women are now getting antiretroviral drugs to prevent transmission to newborns. But of course, our goal now also needs to be more ambitious, which is the actual elimination of vertical transmission so that fewer, no newborns will be infected.
One of the keys to stopping AIDS is ensuring that the most disadvantaged receive effective and consistent treatment.
We're realizing that reaching the hardest to reach, both mothers who may not come back to clinics for delivery or for children who may fall through the cracks because they are AIDS affected and their families aren't giving them adequate care. UNICEF is trying to shine a spotlight on them.
Because the face of the AIDS epidemic is constantly evolving, UNICEF and its partners are also focusing on the changing needs of those who have literally grown up with the disease.
One of the phenomena of the epidemic is that now thousands, tens of thousands of children who were born HIV positive because of mother-to-child transmission are now reaching their teens, and there's a whole new set of issues, both how they transition from pediatric care to adult care, issues of disclosure, who they tell about their disease and how they live lives as normal teenagers, also adherence to medication, and questions about their own sexuality and their own interrelationship with friends and colleagues. So UNICEF has been working with partners to develop service guidelines, and this is something we can look forward to in 2011, that the issue of HIV-positive adolescents will be even more on everyone's agenda.
Preventing new infections amongst adolescents is another major challenge. 40% of new adult infections are amongst those aged from 15 to 24. UNICEF is calling for more effort from government and leaders to address the complex reasons why young people put themselves at risk of contracting AIDS. This is Chris Niles reporting for UNICEF Television. For more information, visit unicef.org. Unite for Children.